Hey guys, I'm doing overhead squats, but I'm about to cook something finger-lickin. Be sure to stick around for my lemon pepper chicken. Go ahead and gather these ingredients. One plate of chicken, four thighs, four legs, two breasts. 4 cups chicken stock, 8 cups mushrooms. 4 cups onions, 4 cups roasted bell peppers, both julienne. Italian parsley and lemon pepper love. 2 ounces grass-fed butter, 8 cloves sliced garlic, 3 large butternut squash. We're gonna start one of the sheet pans. We're gonna place our butternut squash. That's gonna go directly in the oven. We're gonna cook those until a butter knife, without much pressure, will just fall straight into the shaft of the squash. Make sense? So it's nice and soft. For the chicken, we're gonna dump that in a large bowl. We're gonna go with 1/2 to 3/4 of a cup of our lemon pepper love, something like that, and then some olive oil. Now with this, if you want, you can just use boneless, skinless chicken breast if you're kinda cutting your fat. Who doesn't love a nice drumstick or a thigh though, right? So we're gonna do both on the same pan. Cook these to about 165. I like to put the chicken with the skin and the bones on the outside, the perimeter of the pan, and then the breasts in the middle. I'm gonna get these in the oven and then we'll get started on our veg. So for the complete meal, what we're looking at here is a bed of butternut squash, chicken on top, and then we're gonna cover that with kind of a juicy, soupy mixture of these vegetables. To start that, I've got a preheated cast iron skillet. Get some olive oil going and our garlic. Okay, now we've got a little bit of a toast going on to our garlic. I'm gonna add our onions and then a little pinch of our lemon pepper love. We're gonna lid that, kind of trap the moisture in there, steam those onions, they'll cook a little bit faster that way. And then next up will be our mushrooms. We'll take a look here. Looking good, they're coming right along. So we're gonna get the mushrooms in there. And then I'm gonna give it a little bit of our chicken stock, just to kind of get those mushrooms going and help them release their moisture. Let's work this Italian parsley here. We've got, this is flat leaf parsley or Italian parsley, different from the curly stuff. Don't get the curly stuff. I think they developed that so they could put a little sprig on your lunch tray in second grade, right, in the cafeteria. Did you guys ever get that? Like the orange slice with the little piece of curly parsley? Anyways, this is the stuff to get. I'm gonna pull it from the stem as best as possible. With cilantro, I'll chop the whole stem in with it. I'm not worried about that. But parsley is a little bit woody, so we wanna pull the leaves from the stem. I'm just gonna roughly chop it here, maybe 2-3 times through, and that's good. Let's check on this. There you go. Mushrooms have started to release their moisture. Everything's looking good. So now I'm gonna leave the lid off. Our goal here is to reduce this moisture, which will increase the flavor, concentrate the flavor. I'm gonna say it probably needs about 1 minute before we add the peppers. All right, we're drying out here. This flavor is gonna be amazing. A little butter in there right now would be money. I'm gonna give it a little more lemon pepper and then in with our bell peppers, roasted bell peppers. Mazzetta is a good brand that I like to use. So I prefer to roast my own bell peppers, but we got these ones in the jar. All right, next up is our chicken stock. And then we're just gonna bring that up to temp and monte au beurre. French term for finish with butter. We're gonna use the butter to kind of thicken our sauce at the end, bring some nice flavor in, and then we'll be ready to plate. Here we are, squash is done, chicken's done. Boom, I'm gonna show you guys how to work with the squash. What I'll do is I'll pull it out, cut right here, kind of guess where the bulb and the shaft meet, cut the stem off, and then use a paring knife, and you'll be able to peel away just like that. Move that to the side, and I'll show you how to handle this guy. I cut it there. Again, it'll be easy to peel. All we need now is a small spoon for scraping seeds from squash. A lot of S's going on. And we'll scrape out the center. Okay, the squash is knocked out and our veggies are ready. I'm gonna go ahead with our butter. Turn the heat down. Now we're just kind of folding this in, letting it melt slowly. Okay, I'm gonna cut the heat. Butter's melting, and we'll call that good. Now we're gonna plate this baby up family style. So check this out. All right, guys, there it is, my finger-licking lemon pepper chicken. We've served this up family style, but you can easily do it portioned individually. Get it in your freezer. It's great on the reheat. I gotta get back to my overhead squat. You guys give this one a try, and we'll see you next week.